on the post 2014.
First off, we want to give all glory and praises to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shah, Barak Atham. All glory and praises to our Heavenly Father and His only begotten Son, man. We out here for the 12 tribes of the house of Israel, man. We out here to wake our people up, man. Right? We out to bring our people back to who they are, back to their nationality. Right? So we're going to get into this basic milk right now, and we're going to teach our people color that's in the Bible. Now, we went over this numerous times, but we're going to touch on it and get a little deeper for our people to get clear understanding of what the Bible is truly saying. So go ahead and bring that out, huh?
The book of Acts, chapter 13, and verse 1.
Yeah.
Now, there were in the church that was at Antioch certain prophets and teachers.
Certain prophets and teachers that was in the church at Antioch. Certain prophets and teachers. Now we're going over basic information to let you know that the prophets and the servants of old was black. Go ahead and read.
As Barnabas and Simeon, that was called nigger.
It was called what?
That was called nigger.
It was called what?
That was called nigger.
They always put that term on us because nigger just simply means black. They call us colored people. They call us black. Right? Read that one more time from the top. Huh?
The book of Acts, chapter 13 and verse 1. Now there were in the church that was at Antioch, certain prophets and teachers as Barnabas and Simeon that was called nigger.
So the prophets of old was called nigger. They was called black. Go ahead and give me that in the book of 1 Chronicles 23:14.
The book of 1 Chronicles chapter 23 and verse 14.
Bring it out.
Now concerning Moses, the man of the Most High.
Now this is concerning Moses. We all know about Moses. The Most High God used Moses to deliver the children out of the house of Egypt, out of captivity. Go ahead and read.
His sons were named of the tribe of Levi.
His sons was named of the tribe of Levi. Now we all know when you go to Numbers, what is that, 1 and 18, that it goes about the house of your fathers, right? So this is letting us know that Moses was from the tribe of Levi. Read it again from the top, huh?
The book of 1 Chronicles chapter 23 and verse 14. Now concerning Moses, the man of the Most High, his sons were named of the tribe of Levi. The sons of Moses were Gershom and Eliezer.
And this is going into the sons. Now you can go ahead and jump to the book of Exodus chapter 4 verse 6. Now we know that Moses is from the tribe of Levi now. We got that understanding. Now we're going to get some more clarity on Moses and see what color Moses was. Because it's important. Color matters. Go ahead and read, huh?
The book of Exodus chapter 4 and verse 6.
Bring it up.
And the Lord Yahweh Bashem Yahushai said furthermore unto him, put now thine hand into thy bosom.
So he asked Moses to put thy hand into thy bosom. Go ahead and read.
And he put his hand into his bosom. And when he took it out, behold, his hand was leprous as snow.
His hand was leprous as snow, right? So if I put my hand in my bosom, I'm already brown, so-called black. I'm brown, but if I put my hand in my bosom and it turned as white leprosy, as white as snow, then I'm kind of looking strange. It's just a miracle. Go ahead and read.
And he said, put thine hand into thy bosom again. And he put his hand into his bosom again and plucked it out of his bosom. And behold, it was turned again as his other flesh.
And it went back to his normal flesh. So this is the depiction of Moses, right? And the Lord told Moses to put thy hand in thy bosom. He put it in his bosom and turned white as snow, leprosy. He told him to put his hand back in his bosom and his hand turned back his normal color, which turned back to brown. So that lets you know right there that Moses is from the tribe of Levi and he was brown, like us, our forefathers.
Right.
All right, now go ahead and jump to the book of what I want. Give me Jeremiah 14:2. Right? Color matters, man. Color matters in the Bible. Go ahead and bring that out, huh?
The book of Jeremiah chapter 14 and verse 2. Judah mourneth, and the gates thereof languish. They are black unto the ground.
Now this is the prophet Jeremiah talking about the Jews are black. Jeremiah just saying that the Jews are black. We're black. Point blank period, because it's true. Alright, so go ahead and jump to the book of Jeremiah chapter 8 verse 21. Now Jeremiah said that the Jews are black, so let's get the account of Jeremiah himself and see what color Jeremiah, the prophet Jeremiah, is.
The book of Jeremiah chapter 8 and verse 21.
Bring it out.
For the hurt of the daughter of my people am I hurt. I am black. Astonishment hath taken hold on me.
So this is the prophet Jeremiah, our forefathers. He said he is black. Right? He is black.
That's right.
Black is all, color is all mentioned throughout the Bible. It's just our people need to come back. We out here to give you this milk so you can understand it, so you can come back to who you are, come back to your biblical nationality and wake up. Because this world has been pushing that Christ and all the prophets is a so-called white man for too long. Those are lies. We out here to bring our people back to the truth. That's what we out here for. So go ahead and give me that in the book of what I want. Job 30 and 30, Hebrew. Job 30 verse 30. Let's find out what color Job was according to the Bible. Because it's all documented, so we got to read it. Because guess what? Your pastors in the church buildings, they're not going to read this to our people. I never heard this since I was growing up and I went to church. Go ahead and read, huh?
The book of Job, chapter 30 and verse 30. My skin is black upon me.
What did Job say?
My skin is black upon me.
Hey, the prophet Job said his skin is black upon him. Go ahead and give him that in the book of Romans, chapter 11, verse 1. Now we're going to go to Paul, because everybody get Paul's letters confused, right? They say Paul was going into the Gentiles and waking up the Gentiles, and they talking about the Gentiles of the other nations, the so-called white man and all the other nations, but the Gentiles was simply us. We're going to get into that. Go ahead and read.
The book of Romans, chapter 11, and verse 1. I say then, hath the Most High cast away his people? The Most High forbid.
God did not cast away the children of Israel, because that's who God's people are. You blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, to make it clear, go ahead and read.
For I also am an Israelite of the seed of Abraham, of the tribe of Benjamin.
So this is Paul talking about he's an Israelite from the tribe of Benjamin. Those would be your Jamaicans today. That's right, Paul was a Jamaican. Go ahead and give me that in the book of Acts, chapter 21, verse 37, Hebrew. And let's read upon it. Let's find out what color Paul was. Does everybody want to get Paul letters misconstrued? Go ahead and read, huh?
The book of Acts, chapter 21, and verse 37.
Bring it out.
And as Paul was to be led into the castle, he said unto the chief captain, may I speak unto thee? Who said, canst thou speak Greek?
Can thou speak Greek? Go ahead and read.
Art not thou that Egyptian, which before these days made us an uproar and led us out into the wilderness 4,000 men that were murderers? But Paul said, I am a man which am a Jew of Tarsus.
Which is a Jew. Paul said, no, I'm a Jew. I'm a man from the tribe. I'm a Jew, right? Because the Egyptians took, well, the Greeks took Paul for an Egyptian. Now, we all know that the Egyptians was black.
That's right.
So he mistaken Paul for that Egyptian that got his whole team slaughtered in the wilderness, man. Right? So we bringing out color because it's matter. Go ahead and give me that in the book of Hebrews chapter 7:14. Now we all know this verse. We all know this scriptures, right? We all by now should know what color our Messiah was, all right? Because it's important. You can't be going around claiming somebody else is your Messiah and you believe in that thing and think you're going to get delivered when he comes and he's another color or another race. Bring that out, Ark.
The book of Hebrews, chapter 7, and verse 14.
Yep.
For it is evident that our Lord sprang out of Judah.
It is evident, man, that our Lord sprang out of Judah. So the Lord is from the tribe of Judah. So go ahead and you know what I want. Revelations 1:14. Our Lord came out of Judah. He sprang out of Judah. He come from the seed of Judah, right? So thus far, we got Moses from the tribe of Levi. We got Paul from the tribe of Benjamin. And now we got speaking on our Lord and Savior. Go ahead and read.
The book of Revelation, chapter 1, and verse 14.
Get out.
His head and his hair were white like wool, as white as snow, and his eyes were as a flame of fire, and his feet like unto fine brass, as if they burned in a furnace, and his voice as the sound of many waters.
So this is the colors that's depicted in our Holy Bible, right? And Paul said, have God cast away his people? Paul said, God forbid, man. He never cast the children of Israel away, right? He never did that, right? He's still for us and he's still for us today. We're just in a punishment, so it may feel like the Lord is not with us, but he's chastising us. Now that's love. When you love your children, you chastise them when they do wrong so they can get it right. That's why he gave us grace. Our Messiah came back to give us grace so we can get it right. That's all that is. Now go ahead and give me another book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 1.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, and verse 1.
Bring it out.
And it shall come to pass if thou shalt hearken diligently unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe and to do all his commandments, which I command thee this day, that the Lord thy God will set thee on high above all nations of the earth.
Now the Lord gonna set his children of Israel on high above all the nations on the earth if we hearken unto his commandments. Go ahead and get the flip side out.
The book of Deuteronomy chapter 28 and verse 15. But it shall come to pass, if thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe to do all his commandments and his statutes, which I command thee this day, that all these curses,
all these curses
shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
So now the children of Israel had a two-sided coin, a double-sided coin, right? If we will hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God, we will be all right on top of all the people on the earth.
Right.
But if we will not listen, we will be cursed. You know what I want, Daniel 9 and 10, right? So now we got to see, did the children of Israel listen or did they not listen? And it's important for us to bring the milk because a lot of our people is not on the meat. If I bring out the meat and go into the seven heads and the 10 horns, our people would be lost. That's going into different nations. Our people don't even understand that. Our people don't go that far back in history. Go ahead and bring that out, huh?
The book of Daniel chapter 9 and verse 10. Neither have we obeyed the voice of the Lord our God to walk in his laws which he set before us.
So the children of Israel did not walk according to the Most High God laws. We didn't listen to Moses, neither did we listen to our Lord. Moses gave us straight directions, man, and we didn't take heed. Go ahead and read.
To walk in his laws, which he set before us by his servants, the prophets, yea, all Israel have transgressed thy law, even by departing, that they might not obey thy voice. Therefore, the curse is poured upon us.
Now the curse is poured upon us, right? Now we're cursed as a people. Now I can give you some clear understanding as why we in a low state, right? While we're on the bottom of society, because we're cursed. Now, this is to answer your questions, why we are on the bottom of society. God cursed us, man. God put us on the bottom because we didn't obey his word. Now, the only how we come up off of the bottom is by being obedient children and coming back to his word, man, and following his law, statutes, and commandment that was commanded to us by Moses. It's simple. It's plain, right? Especially in these last days when we got this information now. We're living in the information age, right? So let's get some curses, a couple curses. We're going to move on. Give me the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 42. Can start at 43.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 43.
Get out.
The stranger that is within thee shall get up above thee very high.
Now, the strangers is the other nations, the heathen nations. The Lord said one of the curses that's going to be on the children of Israel is that the heathen shall get up above us very high. Go ahead and read, huh?
And thou shalt come down very low.
And the children of Israel, you're going to come down very low. Go ahead.
He shall lend to thee, and thou shalt not lend to him.
Hey, the Lord said, because we didn't obey his laws, statutes, and commandments, that we was going to come down very low. And the heathen shall lend to us, and we will not be able to lend to the heathen. That's why we can understand now why we got to go to their banking system.
That's
to get
right.
Loans from them, to get credits for them, right? A lot of our people is flooded with these credit cards, and we ain't even planning on paying it back. Our people like the hell with that credit. I don't care. Hey, give me the most so I can must that up, and then that's just it. Hey, we going to owe the government till I die. That's how our people lead. We think like that, man. We ain't got no intentions on paying that money back. Man, the hell we're paying that money back. They owe us, man.
Right.
But see, they got these chains locked on us and thinking that we doing, they got us believing that they doing for us. But meanwhile, we're still doing for them. They still making money off of us. And we are still slaves. We are in captivity. Till today, pertaining to 1 Maccabees 3 and 8. Right? So go ahead and jump down to 45.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28 and verse 45. Moreover, all these curses shall come upon thee and shall pursue thee and overtake thee till thou be destroyed.
So the Lord said all these curses are going to come upon us, overtake us, until we be destroyed. We know that we destroyed when you don't know your nationality. You know that you destroyed when you don't know your heritage. You know that we destroyed when we on the bottom of society and we don't know why we on the bottom of society. That's a problem. Keep reading up.
Because thou hearkenest not unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
Why this happened to us?
Because thou hearkenest not unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to keep his commandments and his statutes which he commanded thee. And they shall be upon thee for a sign and for a wonder, and upon thy seed forever.
So now these curses is upon us for a sign to let us know that, yes, we are the children of Israel, right? It's a sign. There we go. We are the children of Israel, right? Because these curses are on us for a sign and for a wonder. So right. We remember wonder to ourselves, why am I in a low state? Now we got understanding now. Now we know why we're in a low state. So now that we know that we're in a low state, and now that we know that we're on punishment, now we can get ourselves off of punishment by coming back to the law, statutes, and commandments, and being obedient. Go ahead and give me that in the book of Proverbs, chapter 7, verse 2, Hebrew. Matter of fact, give me Romans 12. Romans 7 and 12, Bach. Romans 7 and 12. Because we're bringing our people to milk. Our people got to understand these things. We want to bring it out simple and plain for our people to understand it. Go to read what you got out.
The book of Romans, chapter 7 and verse 12. Wherefore, the law is holy.
The law is holy. What else, Ock?
And the commandment holy.
And the commandments is holy. Go ahead, Ock.
And just.
And what?
And just.
What else, Ock?
And good.
And good.
That's right.
So that's what we got to do to come back to being obedient children. That means we got to turn away from the world. We got to turn away from the folly. We got to turn away from the darkness. We got to turn away from the evil deeds that our people love to do, because we was confused and didn't know that we had to keep his laws as the commandments. But now we out here to bring our people back to the fold. And in order to come back to the fold, you got to come back to keeping God's laws, statutes, and commandments.
Right.
Point blank, period. It ain't no way around it. Go ahead and give me another book of Proverbs, chapter 7 and 2, Ock. Proverbs 7 and 2. Basic milk. Basic food for our people to eat up and get that understanding, man. Right? Our people know that we black now. Our prophets of old was black.
That's right.
That was our forefathers. We ain't out here lying. Hey, we're not Esau. We're not no heathen nation that's going to claim to be somebody else. We're just not that type of people to claim to be another race or another nation. Hey, that's a low. That's a low blow, man. Go ahead and read, Ark.
The book of Proverbs, chapter 7 and verse 2. Keep my commandments and live.
Keep my what?
Keep my commandments and live.
Because too many of our people is dying because what? They ain't walking according to the law, statutes, and commandments. Right? A lot of our people be warned, too. The Lord makes sure our people hear this truth before he take them out, before he send that death angel their way. He makes sure they get this. And a lot of people that die, a lot of them scoff against the prophets, man, or the servants of the men of the Lord. Go ahead and read that one from the top, Ark.
The book of Proverbs, chapter 7 and verse 2. Keep my commandments and live, and my law as the apple of thine eye.
And thy law is the apple of our Heavenly Father's eye. Our Lord only cares about the obedient children that's doing his Father's will, man.
Right.
He's doing his Father's will. Go ahead and give me that in the book of John, chapter 14, verse 6. Right? Basic instructions. Basic knowledge for our people to understand. Easy to grasp, man. Right? Go to bring that out, Ock.
The book of John, chapter 7, and verse 14.
Bring it out.
Now, about the midst of the feast, Yahushua went up into the temple and taught. And the Jews marveled, saying, how knoweth this man letters, having never learned?
That's John 14, 6.
Oh, slack it.
I need John 14, 6, Hebrew.
The book of John, chapter 14, and verse 6.
Bring it out.
And it reads, Yahushua saith unto him, I am the way.
Is the what?
I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me.
So we got to go to our Lord to ask for everything. We got to pray to our Lord. You can pray to the Heavenly Father as well. But don't leave the Heavenly Father. Don't leave our Lord out and just constantly pray to the Heavenly Father. That's off, man. Read that one more time, Hebrew.
The book of John, chapter 14 and verse 6. Yahushua saith unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me.
But by him. Plain, simple instructions. Right? And that's what we are. Go ahead and give me that Deuteronomy 7 and 6, man. Let's tell or show our people how special we are. Now that we know that the curses is upon us, we must know how special we are in the Most High eyes. Go ahead and read.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 7 and verse 6.
Bring it out.
For thou art an holy people unto the Lord thy God. The Lord thy God has chosen thee to be a special people unto himself above all people that are upon the face of the earth.
So the Lord just said, you children of Israel, you blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, we are the most precious things. We the most beautiful is creation on the earth. And we are above all people, all races on the earth. Because the laws was given to us. Right. The laws was not given to everybody.
Right.
Why don't you give me that in the book of Psalms, chapter 147:19? Let's prove this with the words, man. The laws was not given to everybody, man. Go ahead and bring that out, Hebrew.
The book of Psalms, chapter 147 and verse 19.
Read it out.
He showeth his word unto Jacob, and his statutes and his judgments unto Israel.
The northern and the southern kingdom. Keep reading.
He hath not dealt so with any nation, and as for his judgments, they have not known them. Praise ye the Lord.
So the Lord gave his word, his statutes and his commandments to the children of Israel.
That's right.
He ain't give them to everybody.
Uh-huh.
Let me give me the book of Amos chapter 3 verse 1. Everybody did not get this medicine right here. It's not for everybody. He's about his special people, which is you blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, the Israelites that the Bible speaks of. Hey, y'all, supposed to, y'all got to hear the word? Y'all believe in God? Y'all want to hear the word? Y'all need to repent and turn back to God's laws as the commandments.
Right.
Bring that out, huh?
The book of Amos, chapter 3, and verse 1.
Bring it out.
Hear this word that the Lord, Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai, has spoken against you, O children of Israel, against the whole family which I brought up from the land of Egypt, saying, you only have I known.
The Lord said, he only knows us. You only have I known. Go ahead and read, huh?
Of all the families of the earth.
Of what?
Of all the families of the earth.
We only have he known. That's you blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. The 12 tribes and house of Israel is you only have I known of all the families of the earth. Go ahead and read.
Therefore, I will punish you for all of your iniquities.
So there, he gonna punish us for all of our sins.
That's right.
Iniquity means sin.
That's
right. We the ones get punished for our sins. And when we go off and do something wrong, it's a consequence for it.
That's right.
But the heathen nation, they do stuff wrong, they get away with it all the time. And I know a lot of our people would look at this and be like, dang, this ain't fair. The Lord ain't treating us fair. Now we know why the Lord is not treating us fair. Let me give you that in the book of Romans chapter 9 verse 4. Huh? Now we can understand why the Lord treating us the way he's treating us, man. He's chastising us for us to get it right. But bring that out, huh?
The book of Romans chapter 9 and verse 4.
Bring it out.
Who are Israelites?
Who are what?
Who are Israelites?
We don't not.
To whom the pertaineth the adoption.
We pertain the adoption. What else?
And the glory.
And the what?
And the glory.
What else, Sock?
And the covenant.
And the what?
And the covenant.
What else, Sock?
And the giving of the law.
And the what?
And the giving of the law.
And the what?
And the giving of the law.
Only the children of Israel was given of the law.
That's right.
Everybody else was not given of the law. We must understand that, Israel. A lot of this the thing. The pastor in the Christian church too busy teaching our people that God loves everybody, and they painted that picture so nice, beautiful, and pretty. Our people just stuck on it. They cleave to that picture. But it's not the truth. We cleave it to a lie. Because that's what it is. And that's why a lot of our people don't want to wake up. The reason why our people don't want to wake up is because we hate to do and follow instructions. We want to do our own thing. And the other thing with that is our people love to turn up in wickedness. We so been in wickedness for so long, we don't want to change and be righteous, man. Our people don't want to come back home. We don't want to come back to who we are. Our people say, forget our nationality. I don't care about that no more. I'm a nigger. I'm an African American. But that's not the way. We got to come back to the Most High God. Go ahead and give me that in the book of, what I want, 2 Ezra chapter 7, verse 6. Let's get that account, man. Because we are supposed to be chasing the kingdom. We are supposed to be trying to save our souls.
That's right.
Right? We all should be trying to make ourselves better. Go ahead and read up.
The book of 2 Ezra chapter 7 and verse 6.
Bring it out.
There is also another thing. A city is builded and set upon a broad field.
Now this is the kingdom of heaven. Go ahead and read.
And it's full of all good things.
It's full of all good things, man. Things our mind can't even comprehend. Go ahead and read.
The entrance thereof is narrow.
The what?
The entrance thereof is narrow.
The entrance thereof is narrow. That thing tight. You gain too much weight, you can't fit. It's like a crack. It's too narrow, right? That means we got to follow the laws, that's the commandments, because those are things that's going to get us in there, as well as our faith.
Teacher.
Go ahead and read.
And it's set in a dangerous place.
It's set in a dangerous place. Go ahead.
To fall, like as if there were a fire on the right hand, and on the left, a deep water.
So it's like there's a fire on one side and a deep water on the next. That means it's saying that it's kind of hard to get through. That's what it said. Everybody can't fit, right? And Esau was blessed with the fatness of the earth.
That's
He's
right.
a fat man. If you rich, you can't get the kingdom. Straight like right. that. We all know about that. Go ahead and read.
And one only path between them both, even between the fire and
now, it's only one path between the fire and the water, man. One path. You know how hard people will see something that we can't get through, and we'll try to look for another way around it? We'll try to go on the top of something, dig a hole down. We can't get there. We'll try to dig a hole on the right-hand side of it, go through the rocks. We even try to dig a hole up under to go through, but this type of entrance way is not like that.
Right.
It's only one way, and it's tight and it's narrow, right? Go ahead and read.
So small that there could but one man go there at once.
And it's so tight, it's only one man can go there at once, that can fit through there at once. That means you can't take your relatives with you, right? You can't take your co-workers there with you, right? Go ahead and read.
If this city now were given unto a man for an inheritance, if he never shall pass the danger set before it, how shall he receive this inheritance? And I said, it is so, Lord, that then said he unto me, even so also is Israel's portion.
Also is Israel's portion. That's our portion. All you got to do is come back to God's law, statutes, and commandments, be obedient children, and have that faith. You got to know that the Lord is with you. You got to know that thing. You can't say, I believe. Hey, the people in the Christian church, I like to get on them, man, because they hypocrites.
Mm.
The people in the Christian church are so much of hypocrites. They say they believe on God, but they don't do nothing that God say. But in their own mind, they going to get the kingdom. We cannot be like that, Israel. We got to go about the instructions. This gives us the way on how to get the kingdom. So if it's telling us we got to keep the law, such as the commandments, and have faith, then that's the role we got to take.
Right.
If you truly want the kingdom. If you don't want the kingdom, then hey, it's take the broad way. Point blank period. Go ahead and read, Doc.
Because for their sakes, I made the world.
Because for what?
Because for their sakes, I made the world.
He made the whole world for the children of Israel.
That's
man.
Right.
But the children of Israel messed up, man. Hey, they ain't want to listen to God. We had it so good, we said, we're going to do our own thing. Right? You know how our people get big-headed, man. We get prideful as a people. When we come upon a nice, large amount of money, we think we all that. We think we run something now. We ain't got to listen to nobody no more. Can't nobody tell me nothing. I got all I want now. I get my own crib. I get my own car. Can't nobody tell me nothing. That's what happened. We got big-headed. The Lord gave us the whole earth, and we said, look, man, I don't want to listen to the Lord no more. Okay, and now we getting our ass whooped. A lot of our people don't know why. But we're telling you why, right? We're telling our people why, man. So with that, let's go ahead and go to the book of what I want. Deuteronomy 28. Deuteronomy 28, verse 68.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, and verse 68.
Bring it out.
And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again with ships, by the way there whereof I spake unto thee, thou shalt see it no more again, and there ye shall be sold unto your enemies.
The Lord said we were going to be sold unto our enemies. This is another stumbling block. Our people refuse to believe that we got enemies, unless it's from our own kind. The other nations don't hate us.